I've got Gabe.
You have designed so many different gardens all over the world. Now your own personal garden. How old is this and what is the concept here?
Our garden, we moved here, my wife and I, in the 82. And we started, we were a design office in the western part of the Netherlands. And we moved to this area because we wanted more space to grow plants. Because we love plants, and planting is one of the, let's say, one of my identity. That's how, where people know me from in design. So we needed more space to grow plants and to learn to know them, how they grow. So we started in the 80s and worked ourselves to a lot of experience to do what we do now. And what we do now is creating parks and landscapes on a large scale, which is completely different from the beginning. You want to know what?
The different garden spaces.
Okay.
Space.
Okay. So when we came here in 82, we started just to build up the house and the nursery. So we had not much time to build gardens, but we started with the front garden. There's one big border left. The border is, I think, 20 years old. That was our first sort of border, big planting bed we planted. In the front garden we had a trial garden, so we collected a lot of plants from all over Europe, and we put them there in the front and to see what they would do and how we could work with them, how we could use them in our designs. So many years after, I think that was the nursery part, of course, was here in the back. We started to develop more of the garden. So the trial garden became a show garden, and the back of the garden was just plants for cuttings and propagation. So the nursery was a big thing. We became very well known with the plants we were selling all over Europe. My design was well known, but took off after, really took off after 2000, the year 2000, when we, I did some work in England, and I got a lot of commissions from America and from Sweden and from England. So then my bigger work took off. But in the meantime, we were just developing the show gardens here. So we changed the front garden in the meantime 3 times. And now it's more and more natural, which is became my style and the style that people know me for. It's natural, but in fact it is not nature. So plants are chosen for their more naturalistic look. So that they wouldn't look over-cultivated. And by using grasses in our planting schemes, people thought that we were making wild gardens. But all the plants we are using are not wild. They are just behaving quite well. But by using grasses, people thought that we were making wild gardens. But what we don't do is making nature. We just try to create an image that reminds you of nature.
Plants you are using are usable like in North America, North Europe, everywhere.
The plants are, in fact, hardy, durable plants, real perennial plants. If you work in other people's gardens, you cannot allow yourself to use plants that are very short-lived. So we had to make choices, and because of our experience, we know more or less what plants do. So when I work in other places or for other people, plants have to live long, have to be durable. And I think then your palette of plants, the number of plants you can use is very limited. But because we had so much experience, it is more, let's say the number of plants are still very high. So that's why the gardens we make are has a certain complexity because it looks if there's so much going on.
So you have also very interesting and beautiful etching. How all this that, I mean the bushes and etching here.
Mm-hmm. You mean the boundaries or the hedges? Mm-hmm. Yeah, we made them just to create intimacy, so not putting a garden just in the landscape, but just separate your garden from the landscape. And it gives more a private feeling. And also by creating hedges that were not straight, but more loose, they fit very well in the landscape that is behind it. The meadow is an experiment, and an experiment that is necessary for the future of more public landscaping. Public landscaping is changing. People want to use more flowers. They want to create landscapes that are attracting people. But maintenance costs are very high, so there's all sort of experiments with plants and wild plants, how they can work together or compete with each other, so that you can create a landscape that is aesthetically beautiful with a very low maintenance level. What we did here is just use very strong plants, let's say 30 or 35 different strong perennials, and have sown a mixture of native plants through it. So that's why it looks like a meadow. And the emerging plants, the plants that the taller plants come out of this meadow, and they at the end take the attention of the site. So they show off because they are strong and very architectural. And if the meadow or the native plants are a little less after the flowering period in spring and early summer, then the North American and perennials and the tall grasses take over the image. So that's how you try to find out what can we do to emphasize a sort of half wild landscape in concerning the image, the picture you want to have. It depends. When the garden is fully grown, we could say that this is hardly any work. So this is the second year, we didn't do much. Of course, if we see a thistle or so, we interfere. We don't want to things overruled by nasty weeds, but we try to let it go as far as it can. So no maintenance, just looking at it where it goes wrong or right. The front garden, we have areas that are in the shade. They need only a few days in a year. That's very little because the ground covers like geranium nodosum, geranium nodosum, and lamium, and other plants like hellebores, they are covering the ground so well that the maintenance is almost none. Just very limited. So the front garden is a lot of work in spring. Even if it is fully grown, you need to take care of it in the months of April till July. So it's 2 months of just maintaining it well, and after that the maintenance is very limited because the plants grow together. And they grow together. They're chosen for also what I say for being strong and no annuals. So you don't have to change your plants. And I would say at this, if you put that against traditional gardening with roses and annuals, it is maybe 30% of that work. Because we are more or less finished with the hard weeding.